Hello, and welcome to CMMI Tech Talk. I am Holly Mangrum Willis. Today, I'm going to talk to you about appraisal challenges and how to resolve them. In this video, I'll cover different issues that can arise during an appraisal and provide you with suggestions on how to handle them. I'll also go over when and how you should end an appraisal. It turns out that in order to be a good lead appraiser, it takes a little bit more than just following the rules in the MDD and evaluating evidence to determine if the intent and value of each model practice is met. To be an outstanding lead appraiser, you also need to handle the various situations that will come up before, during, and after an appraisal event. Some situations can be easily addressed, such as an appraisal team member misinterpreting a practice because of questions posed in the interview. Others are a bit stickier, like the appraisal sponsor mistakenly believing she can participate in the generation of preliminary findings. And others are downright alarming, such as an appraisal team providing a full set of documentation that was generated by an unethical CMMI consulting firm for the purposes of ensuring the organization passes their appraisal. Most of these situations can be averted or addressed by an experienced lead appraiser in a way that protects the integrity of the appraisal. And that happens by knowing and following the MDD. Of course, when all else fails, the appraisal method definition document, MDD, does offer a nuclear option. If at any point in time during the appraisal activities, the MDD requirements are not maintained or the integrity of the appraisal is compromised, the ATL may stop the appraisal event. Examples that may warrant an appraisal event ending prematurely include: appraisal participants do not maintain confidentiality, consensus by the ATMs cannot be reached, evidence is being created or altered during the event for the sole purpose of the appraisal, or it becomes apparent that honest and accurate information is not being provided. So how does an experienced lead appraiser handle the case where an appraisal team member misinterprets the practice? Some lead appraisers avoid the situation by leading every interview session and asking the vast majority of questions. This allows the appraisal team members to focus on the answers and ask any follow-up or clarification questions. Others prefer that the team members take a more active role in the interviews. In those cases, they typically reserve 10 to 15 minutes at the end for follow-up questions, some of which may be achieving coverage of misinterpreted practices. But whichever approach the lead appraiser chooses, it's their responsibility to verify that all the appraisal team members are properly trained, know the model, and are consistently interpreting it during OE review and characterization processes. What about the appraisal sponsor who insists on participating in the generation of preliminary findings, causing clear breach of confidentiality and a violation of the no observers limitation? The lead appraiser is best served by having a private, one-on-one conversation with the appraisal sponsor to reiterate the confidential nature of the information being discussed and the impropriety of the appraisal sponsor being involved in those conversations. Again, this is where the MDD can be cited by pointing out that this is expressly prohibited in an appraisal. That being said, the lead appraiser must also be able to explain that allowing such a breach would be grounds for decertification, and that one possible outcome is that the appraisal would be terminated if the appraisal sponsor does not reconsider. That is typically enough to demonstrate the lead appraiser's commitment to professional integrity. Remember, the lead appraiser is empowered to stand up to a sponsor's inappropriate requests through ISACA appraisal and quality policies, and of course, through the MDD. And finally, how does an experienced lead appraiser handle suspicions of outright cheating or fraud? In some cases, the organization is so sloppy that they leave incriminating information in the headers or footers of the documents, evidence that clearly displays the name of a different company or project. Such cases of outright deception or fraud are most egregious and, once proven, warrant the most drastic response, potentially reporting the situation to ISACA quality management and shutting down the appraisal. Shutting down an appraisal is the option of last resort, but it must be done in some cases. Your integrity and that of the appraisal and appraisal method must be maintained. You must be able to justify your decisions to your own sense of integrity and professionalism against the MDD and CMMI model and to ISACA quality management. The vast majority of organizations have adopted the CMMI model as a framework to improve their performance, but you can still expect issues to challenge you in such appraisals. On the other hand, a small number of organizations have decided to take unethical liberties to get their certificate. They act dishonorably to avoid doing the hard work, and they need to be stopped from doing so, even if it costs you money. It's especially important to maintain the integrity of an appraisal, whether it is in person or virtual. Virtual appraisals can open the appraisal up for additional issues that a lead appraiser must address. Confidentiality and non-attribution must be maintained during an appraisal. And if it is breached, the appraisal should be terminated. It's important that the lead appraiser address this in the opening brief, remind participants during each interview session, and ensure that their cameras are turned on and that they are not multitasking. If a participant is typing feverishly during an appraisal, they may not be maintaining integrity, confidentiality, and non-attribution. If you find that an appraisal participant is being fed answers virtually, you will need to pause the appraisal and investigate further to determine the best path forward and whether the appraisal can continue. And the last point. For the organization being appraised, a successful appraisal is one in which they achieve their target maturity level, including demonstrating the expected performance outcomes. To the lead appraiser and hopefully to the appraisal team, a successful appraisal is one in which the organization is given the maturity level they deserve. Thank you for joining me for this Tech Talk. If you have any additional questions, please get in touch with us at support.isaca.org.